before you run up. Ready, get you done.
Yo, microphone check, 1, 2, what is this? The 5 foot with the roughneck business. I float like gravity, never had a cavity. Got more rhymes than the one that's got family. No need to sweat Arsenio to gain some type of fame. No shame in my game, cause I always be the same. Styles upon styles upon styles is what I have. You wanna just to fight for, but you still don't know the half. I sport New Balance sneakers to avoid a narrow path. Messing around with this, you can't size it up. I never have stuff, cause I'm not a half stepper. Drink a lot of soda, so they call me Dr. Pepper. Refuse to compete with competition. Your name is special, so won't you suckle with the mission? I never walk this street, think it's all about me. Even though deep in my heart, it really could be. I just try my best to like go all out. Some might even say you're shorty black, you're bugging out.
Duke, do you have a second? Your last college game, you just scored a career high 36 points in a losing effort against what everyone has been saying is
the team of the century. That's got to be bittersweet. No one gave you a chance, and you almost pulled off the upset of all time. What are your emotions right now, Duke?
You know, I missed the shot. This is my family. And I let them down. That's all there is to it. Thank you. Thanks.
Thank you.
Duke, do you have a second? Your last college game, you just scored a career high 36 points in a losing effort against what everyone has been saying. It's the team of the
saw your indictment tonight. Those were grown men. Good players. Season. A couple of them played D1. Held your own. That's the real game, right? Outside the gym.
You follow me out here?
Let's just say that I'm in the city a lot, and we just happen to be there at the same time. You can play. Your footwork and floor spacing needs a bit of cleanup.
Yeah, I told you I'm a football player.
Yeah, you're a senior now.
And I told you I am a football
player. How many D1 player football offers you got so far? Tough, committed, plays the game the right way. You're a great player. Great isn't special.
Oh, come on, coach. That's your pitch. Trash, get in his job.
Not a pitch.
Still hope.
Stoudemire, Duncan didn't play organized ball until they were 14. Steve Francis was 16. Giannis was playing soccer until someone wised up, probably gave him the same speech. And now he's an MVP.
Okay, so what, coach? I mean, I'm not just some charity case you want to help out. What's in it for you?
Right. Wins. I have a lot of good kids. I need special.
Not special.
Your natural ability is, yes.
If I play basketball again, starts all over. Those questions. It becomes about him again. It's never been just me, it's always been us.
Stop running and take him on. When we first met, you told me how you loved, you were bled, you were. You wanted to be part of a bigger world. This is how you get it.
Maybe football is your game. I mean, you play like you're trying to run your head through a brick wall. Nah, this game ain't for you. This game's all about nuance. Subtlety, son. Paul Frazier, Bill Russell, MJ.
Yeah, what about LeBron? He was a football player.
You ever seen that man pass? That's the beautiful game right there.
Yo, Duke, great to see you on the court again, baby.
Yo, we saw you win state. Brick City for real, son.
Thank you, appreciate y'all. See that, son, right there? That's what I'm about.
What are you about?
Right now, this is a rebirth. We are only as strong as our belief in each other. Yeah?
Yeah.
All right. Come on. All right, let's go now, Breeden. Are you ready?
Yeah.
I said, are you ready?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3.
Eagles.
Junior, just a second. No pressure here. All you gotta do is be better than me in my first game. Yeah.
All right, so what happened?
Just aim for more points than turnovers, all right? And you'll do fine. This is your moment.
Thanks, Coach. Enjoy it.
Let's go, baby!
Hello, everyone, and welcome to this broadcast of Garden State IAA Basketball. I'm Joe Lamy, joined by Drake Hugo and Danny Hauger. We can't wait to get another season rolling, and we look to get a great matchup to kick things off.
Well, a classic matchup with the Newark East Eagles playing host to the Burton Hornets. Both teams looking to improve on their final positions from last year. A win tonight would be a great step towards that goal.
They go against an Eagles team with quite a few new faces. Still though, Newark is led by senior KJ Day.
And the crowd will be a factor here for the Eagles. This is the type of atmosphere you love to see at the high school level. New year and a new lineup. Day, the team captain, he'll now start at the two with newcomer junior playing the point. Black and Zadirko fill in at the forwards, and Marceda steps in to get the start at center. And the Hornets come in with their usual lineup. Luan and Dermanenko are in the backcourt. Star forward Bobby Erickson begins the game at the three. Ramadas and Aslanoglu fill out the 4 and 5 spots.
And one thing you'll notice with the Hornets this season, a younger starting lineup than most. Only 2 seniors starting for this team.
Well, Danny, their coach put every starting spot up for grabs before the season. He made every player earn their position. A few juniors and even a sophomore stepped up. You have to love the future of Hornets basketball with the talent their underclassmen have shown.
To the paint. The Zadirko shot is good.
I like the junior is always paying attention. He sees opportunity forming and he moves the ball to the open man.
Their offense has stagnated.
It's been hard to watch. They need a bucket and soon.
Levesque with it. Junior's there. James Marceda with the block. And it's out of bounds. The Hornets able to retain possession here. Porter, he's guarded by Marceda. Pass to Dermanenko. Takes a three, knocks it down from distance. And the Hornets and their roster, they aren't scared to play small if they need to.
Looking at the rest of the division, the Hornets are one of the smaller teams overall. They just don't have that many big bodies in the program, but they know how to make up for it with defensive rotations. Don't be fooled, this team is still deadly, albeit a tad undersized.
Now here's Levesque, tight defense on him. Back to Porter. That's in, coming off an assist from Bobby Erickson.
He's playing unselfish basketball in this game. Good look on that pass by Erickson of the Hornets.
A drive by Junior, and it's good. Fought through the contact, hit the shot, and will go to the line.
It's funny to think that not too long ago, Junior wasn't even thinking about basketball. He was focused on football. It's obvious now that he made a good call to switch to hoops.
Burton with the ball, trailing by 4. Ramadas outside. Dermanenko. And here's Steven Porter from the arc. Junior outside. Pass to Zadirko. Junior. On the wing, Junior. The three ball. Score the bucket. His fourth of the game, missing only one so far. He's now shooting 4 for 5 tonight. And you look at the play style of Bobby Erickson, very much a modern wing who can play off the ball or initiate things for this offense as well.
And Erickson might be lined up out on the wing, but he'll do pretty much everything you ask of him in this offense. Coach figured out very quickly this team is at its best when Erickson has the ball in his hands.
Now here's Erickson. Black pulls it down. Here's Junior. Rebounded by the Hornets. Outside Erickson. Pass to Levesque. Dermanenko. And first quarter, we're about 3.5 minutes in. James Marcedo with the block.
I love when Marcedo leverages his reach and height on D, able to cleanly deny the shot attempt.
Here's Sheffield. Here's Adirko. It's stolen by Ramadas. Now here's Levesque, covered by Junior. Vlad Dermanenko on the wing. Back to Levesque. Junior with the steal. And he drops in the layup off the glass.
They're getting good shots close to the basket. 5 of their last 6 attempts have now gone in.
Taking it right at the defense and converting.
And looking at Junior, the senior is exactly the type of guard the Eagles needed for this season.
Absolutely. He clearly is a plus athlete. And even though he hasn't spent too much time perfecting his skills, the pedigree is there with who his dad is.
Bobby Erickson for 3. And the ball goes out of play. The Eagles will have it. Very smooth pace to this offense.
And they're looking to keep building on this momentum with this run.
7-second difference between the shot and game clock. Here's Junior. It falls for the 7th bucket of the contest, shooting 7 for 9 today.
He's come alive with his scoring, giving them everything they could hope for.
Pass to Porter.
A quick foul to pick up right away here in the first quarter.
He gets the shot to fall, and the defender wasn't set. He's called for... Both teams making some changes here. We're around 2 minutes into this second quarter of play. And a foul called on Junior. That'll be his 2nd foul of the game.
Now, having picked up a couple fouls early, he's forcing his coach to have to make a decision.
Right wing. Shot from 12. And the basket by Levesque.
Well, seeing Junior out there, you can't help but think of his legendary father, Duke. One of the biggest names in the area.
Junior. And so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot 2. And Duke, a star here at Newark, who went on to have a great run at the collegiate level.
And to call Duke a high school star doesn't even begin to paint the full picture. Everyone from that era knew who Duke was. I'm sure they're ecstatic to see what Junior can do.
Both fall at the line that time.
They're finding ways to get to that line. I like how they've upped their aggressiveness.
Yeah, and the opposition has to be careful. You don't want to just hand them easy points.
Outside Erickson. Dermanenko outside from past the arc. And that'll be Burton's ball as it goes out of bounds. Hornets able to keep the ball here. Second quarter of play with almost 3 minutes gone by so far. Returns it to Erickson. And you can count it. He'll go to the line with a chance to make it 3.
And after a very quiet start to the game, he's come alive here in the second. Erickson is the number one reason teams dread playing the Hornets. He is so tough to game plan for. A three-level scorer and solid facilitator, too. Well, you have to love the charm of the Newark East Gym. The facility might not be top of the line.
We conclude the first half. Eagles ahead. They lead by 12. And we'll be back to bring y'all the third quarter action after halftime. Second half of play getting going. Newark East Eagles with a big lead after two quarters of play. Dermanenko with it. Pass to Erickson. Dermanenko returns it to Erickson. And it's going to be a goaltending call here, so they'll count the basket.
Oh, okay, Erickson. I do. I see you. Look at the moves this kid has. Such a creative ball handler.
Junior, left side. Outside for Lack. Back to Junior. And they double up Junior. Down it goes for the eighth time in 10 attempts.
Gotta commend the focus. Junior taking the contact well and finding a way to score.
They are desperate for a score here, to say the least.
Their last score getting farther and farther away. They need to get something going.
And the last few seasons, the Eagles haven't had an easy time finding wins.
For a while, it seemed you could always count on the Eagles to be at the top of this conference. That hasn't been the case lately. Hopefully, Coach Bishop has found the talent he needs to get his program back to the top.
Junior inside. He's covered by Levesque. That's no basket. His third miss in 11 attempts. Burton trailing here. Vlad Dermanenko for three.
When you get that clean of a look, you have to take it and hope you make it.
Down low. Marceda, that's good.
Let the big man eat down there. Once again, Marceda has the positioning he likes, and the rest is history.
And here's Levesque. Dermanenko outside. Back to Levesque. Dermanenko. Outside Levesque. Erickson defended by Lack. Clock at six. And here's Joe Levesque outside. And once again, off the mark by Burton.
No doubt the star of this Burton squad is Bobby Erickson. He's a gifted scorer and playmaker. And he's been with the Hornets for quite some time now, and he's been the star. A little showmanship on display as he increases the lead.
That's gotta be a tough pill for the defense to swallow.
Well, guys, we know he can hurt you with his passing, and right there, he does some damage with his finishing, too.
And with Erickson, guys, you see his release, and you know immediately he's a terrific shooter. He's gonna have no problems putting it on the floor as well.
That's true. I mean, Erickson plays bigger than he actually is, and that helps him finish on the inside. Colleges have shown a lot of interest in him since his breakout performance his sophomore year. He'll most likely be transitioning to shooting guard when he gets to that next level.
Second half of play, and we're 3 minutes into the third here. Bradley James on the wing. Pass to Leftos. Junior grabs the miss. Makes it off the glass.
Their last five buckets coming in the painted area.
And defensively, you gotta make the adjustment. Force them to make a perimeter shot.
Outside Luan, poked away. And that one drops.
Impressive agility from Luan to make it work inside. You can tell he's been working hard to build that inside shot.
And with Junior, you don't want to only talk about who his father is. but it's a shadow he'll be under as long as he's on the hardwood.
It might be the reason why Junior didn't immediately take to basketball as a sport, but the similarities in their games are already apparent. Junior looks to be just as talented as his dad was, even if he's a bit raw.
And a foul called on Junior. That's it for him. He's fouled out of this one.
Another turnover for them. But guys, I'm a...
And the final horn sounds. Chalk one up for the Eagles. They get the win here at home and a fantastic start to the season.
Yo, look who's got some serious skills.
You like that? You like that?
Kid, that was something special watching you out there tonight.
Yo, wait, wait up.
Wait. Man, how you doing, kid? My name is Archie. Archie Baldwin. Dad and I were teammates.
Yeah, I think I remember that. Can't remember, though, for sure. I was just a little kid when you were still playing ball.
Well, he sure loved you. Talked about you all the time. There was a story about a purple jumper. You had to wear this thing every day or you would
blue.
Cry.
But nice to meet you, Archie?
Yeah,
nice to meet
look, I'll get right to the point. Upside, off the charts. Strong basketball IQ, high motor, understand tempo. It's a package. Easy to sell.
Sell?
Yeah.
It's cool. Like, scholarship?
Exactly.
Is that something you think, or something you know you can do?
It's only one game. You show me what you got on the next one, bring me some high numbers, and we'll talk. But for right now, enjoy the moment.
You said Archie, right?
Archie Baldwin.
Yeah, the word demise.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome. We have another exciting edition of Garden State IAA Hoops for you. I'm Joe Lamy. To my side are Drake Hugo and Danny Hogger. We'll be seeing the Renfield Foxes play host to the Newark East Eagles.
And at this point in the season, we know that we can expect an intense matchup. The Eagles are a much improved team looking to come into Renfield and take one on the road. It won't be easy, but they have the firepower to make it happen.
And standing in their way will be Connor Rosenberg, the fantastic guard for the Renfield Foxes. He's got size, touch, just about everything. You can bet he'll be a handful for the Eagles.
This beautiful gymnasium will be rocking in no time as the Foxes defend their court against the Eagles. A look at the lineup for Newark East. You have Junior running point guard duties. He's joined by Day in the backcourt. And in the middle, it's going to be Marceda. And the rest of the front court is Lack at the three with Zadirko at the four. Fox is starting with the group of Lee and star sophomore Rosenberg in the backcourt. Joseph and Bishop make up that forward pairing. And it's big Bobby Andrews getting the start at center.
And with Renfield, they care quite a bit about their athletics. Tons of money from donations have found their way to the school. They have a lot to show for it.
Now here's Bishop. Offline with the baseline J. The drive by Junior. And there's the foul on the shot, so he'll go to the line for two. And there's the foul against Renfield.
I like when Junior takes initiative. Being aggressive and getting the D to act on the drive.
And he makes the first. And with Renfield from the gym to their uniforms, you can usually count on everything being state of the art.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Who wouldn't want to play here? It feels like a country club. And as a result, a lot of potential standout athletes will try and get into Renfield's district just because of how nice the facilities are.
Outside, Bishop. Now just a minute played here in the first. The drive now by Junior. Count it, it's good.
I like the urgency of Junior's drive. Plenty of raw potential there. He could develop into an unstoppable move.
And while every game hasn't been smooth sailing for Newark, one thing you can see from this team is they are improving each game.
And Joe, that's a big credit to both Coach Bishop as well as the senior leadership on Newark. It's been a special year for this group in large part to their hard work.
The drive by Junior, and yep, it's good.
And the Eagles coaching staff loves this. Junior, tenacious on these physical finishes.
Pass to Andrews. Bishop. Now about 2 minutes have gone by here in the first. Here's Lee. It's good, and he makes his first shot of the game.
Look how Lee stays nimble through the whole play inside, ready to make any adjustment necessary, getting around the defense.
And it's Junior missing. And he drops in the layup off the glass.
They are winning this game right now, mainly because of his incredible offensive outpour.
Pass to Andrews. Bishop defended by Lack.
And on top of that, this quarter has not been going his way on the offensive end.
Andrews with the steal. And Robert Andrews with the slam.
On the drive, Andrews gets some real momentum going, and he doesn't leave the defense with many good options.
Well, it's been a good start for the season for the Eagles. You can see their confidence grow with each win they notch.
The win helps, but this team knows they have a great roster with the addition of Junior. He's made everyone else better around him, especially with the attention he commands. The body language of this team is completely different than last year. Growing up in Newark has its perks. Junior got to hone his skills on the hard courts, not too far away in New York City. And playing in those pickup games is great experience for a young player.
Swing to Madison. Joseph. Here's Grace. And lots of contact there, missing the shot, and will shoot two. It's on Quinn Mason. First one for him, falls. The Eagles trailing. Here's Junior, and the layup falls.
How about the court awareness? Indra, absolutely superb job. Realizing the D's overcommitment, and what a great dime.
Rosenberg with the ball. Junior's there. Rosenberg with the bucket.
He's able to find a seam in the defense and just lay it right in.
And Renfield, one of the nicer schools in the area, their community puts a lot of time and effort into the school, and the results are easy to see.
Well, it's one of the more affluent areas in the state, and everybody knows it. Still, it's always nice to see a community rally around their high school and give them the resources they need.
Pass to Bishop. That one falls, coming off Robert Andrews' feed.
And with that last bucket, it's another lead change. What a back and forth battle.
These teams, they've matched up every step of the way.
Junior, guarded by Rosenberg. Took him no time at all on that one.
And his scoring has been a really big boost for them today. They've leaned on him, and he's come through.
Back to Rosenberg. Over Junior. And Renfield again with the bucket.
Here's Andrews making a shrewd feed to the wide open man. He's been well coached to know when to give it away.
Here's Lack. And that one's drained from the low block.
I'm not sure that's really the time for the fadeaway, but it counts just the same.
The Fox is trailing. Pass to Andrews. Bishop. Misses from close range.
Okay, what appeared to be an easy 2 points, it just went straight out the window.
And Junior gets it to go. And while Coach Bishop did play ball himself in high school, he wasn't a standout athlete.
I remember hearing about him playing. He's very much of a game manager type of guard. Coach didn't try to do too much with him. He had strong fundamentals and overachieved given his lack of athleticism. Pretty much exactly what you want in a coach. I love when Andrews hustles like this. He's being rewarded for not giving up on the play.
And that one's good for Junior.
They're riding his hot hand for all it's worth.
Rosenberg outside. It's Ben Bishop on the wing. Pass to Andrews. James Marcedo with the block.
I love when Marcedo leverages his reach and height on D, able to cleanly deny the shot attempt.
Here's Junior from down in the low post. It goes.
For me, their ball movement is really standing out. Every basket coming off an assist, it seems like.
Well, the last three buckets have, and these guys are in total unison right now.
We finished one half of play. It's the Eagles leading by 7. And we'll be back to bring y'all the third quarter action after halftime. And the second half getting started. Renfield playing host to Newark East here on Garden State IAA Sports. And here are the Foxes. They trail by 7. And with Rosenberg, you have to be careful of his shot. He owns a very quick and deadly release.
His shooting motion, though, it just looks so easy, doesn't it? One of the best shooters in the state, and it's hard to believe that he's just a sophomore.
And Junior throws it down.
Can't stop this guy right now. Once Junior gets it going, he keeps his foot on the gas pedal.
Lee with it. Junior's there. Controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
Hard fought bucket there. Nice putback.
The drive by Junior. And the foul called on Junior. That is his first foul of the game.
And what a great play to sacrifice his body and take the charge.
And really heads up too. Reading the play and beating him to the spot.
Pass to Andrews. Bishop. Second half of basketball. Just over a minute played so far. Lee covered by Junior. And Junior throws it down.
He's not afraid to take chances on this side of the ball. I love watching Junior anticipate when he should go for steals.
They really need to make an adjustment here.
Agreed. Nothing is working for them offensively. Time for a change.
Pass to Andrews. Bishop. Got a piece of it. And it's off the back rim. No good.
And the center for this team, Robert Andrews, whose teammates call Big Bobby Andrews, is a looming presence for them in the paint.
And even though he's a high schooler, a lot of fans will describe Andrews as having old man strength. He's just very difficult to move or get an edge on with his deceptive brawn.
So the whistle blows on the shot. 2 free throws for the contact there.
This is Lee's experience as a senior coming into play. Knows his best bet is to play into the defender and get to the line.
Second free throw, no good. The Eagles with the lead. And here's Lack for 3. Nails it from 3.
From range, Lack can be so effective. Can't wait to see him looking even better from the arc next year.
Pass to Lee. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Foxes will retain possession.
That was a tight pass. Nice job by the D to disrupt it.
Impressive hustle and determination.
Just under 2.5 minutes into this third quarter now. Now here's Andrews. Bishop. Shoots over Lack.
The second half, off to a bumpy start, only hitting one of their first four shots. It's now a plus five advantage for them in the rebounding category after that one.
Very steady work they've been doing on the interior. Really a well-rounded effort overall.
And Junior, as many of you know, is the son of Duke, one of the largest figures in Newark Hoops history.
And I don't know why Junior waited so long to get into the game of basketball, but I bet his father would be elated now that he's on the floor. Duke was a legend in the area, and Junior would be lucky to have that same kind of impact.
It's rebounded by Renfield. Now here's Lee. A little under 2.5 minutes off the clock now in the third quarter. Now here's Bishop, defended by Lack. Count that one.
Solid little mid-range shot from Bishop. That's smart basketball, taking advantage of any scoring opportunity that comes your way.
And the Eagles will go for a different look here. Drive now by Junior.
He gets that one to fall.
A difficult finish for sure, but Junior loves proving he's up for the challenge.
Let's go.